Yo, what's good, pimps? Welcome back. Today is a massive day for your boy. But before we get into this video, make sure you do something productive, something that gets you closer to that one goal you're trying to accomplish, because that's what we fucking do, baby. You know? I don't even know where to start, bro. I really don't. I'm gonna just set y'all down. And we're gonna have a little heart-to-heart. I haven't done one of these in a while, and The main reason why I haven't done them in a while is because I didn't want to force them. I wanted them to be natural. I really feel like having a talk with y'all. So basically, your boy's moving to LA, and it was very sudden. I honestly wasn't really expecting myself to move to LA, because I honestly wanted to move to Los Angeles. I wanted to move to Arizona. Because I just love Arizona. Arizona's, if y'all haven't been, bro, y'all need to go. Like, Arizona's awesome. Like, not besides like all the fun lifestyle shit that they got, like, it's really beautiful, it's really pretty, the people are really nice and all that sorts of stuff. I never expected to be in the position I'm in now. I feel like time has moved so fast since last year, and you know, a lot of great things happened. You know, we had our ups and downs, we had our roller coasters, but you know, we stayed strong and we stayed true to ourselves, and that's all that matters, you know. And with this move, it's very exciting. You know, I'm super excited because there's just so much to do in Los Angeles, and I think y'all are gonna be excited for the YouTube as well. I'm just gonna be all over the place when it comes to content. 2 videos a week. I'm gonna be on the Discord a lot, which if y'all are in the Discord, I really recommend to join it. It's a bunch of cool ass homies that just talk and shit. But like I said, I'm very excited for this move, but it's also scary, you know, because the last time I moved out of my house was for college. But you know, I that, you know, as y'all know, that didn't work out. But it worked for the better, and you know, I don't know what God has planned for me ahead. And you know, I gotta stay true to myself and stay faithful. Life can turn like that, you know, in a matter of a second. And the reason I wanted to bring up the college part was because I don't know if y'all, for whoever's watching this video, I don't know if y'all know, but I was in college around a year and a half ago, and I just remember being at my place back when I was in college, and you know, I'd lay down at night and I'd think to myself, what am I doing with my life? You know, I'm not doing what I love. I'm here learning about some shit that I don't want to learn about, and I just don't feel alive. You know, I think that's the best way I can put it. I just felt like I was going through the motions. And I had a small glimpse of hope, and it was this social media stuff. And you know, my main goal with the social media stuff was to inspire kids who you know, are in the same position I was. And you know, don't get me wrong, like, you know, I still deal with, you know, my demons and all that shit, but I was able to truly give it my all when it came to something that I was passionate about. And you know, I didn't really have anyone believing me at that time. You know, my family wasn't really happy that I was dropping out of college. I really didn't have that many people I was in contact with when it came to friends. You know, I had my close homies, which, you know, they're forever gonna be there, but it just, I really lacked that that support system, so I had to support myself. I felt like I was in a dark tunnel, and at the end of the tunnel there was this small light, and you know, I wanted to chase that light. I was willing to risk everything I had to make it work. And you know, I worked countless hours. You know, I stayed up long nights, had no sleep, but I loved the journey. The journey made me so happy because I knew I was working towards something that would fulfill me. You know, I was working towards something that I'm passionate about. And you know, I'm blessed to have the platform I have now, the fucking great people that are watching this video as well. I want y'all to know that you're capable of accomplishing anything in your life, anything possible. Because when I was in, you know, college, laying down in my room at night thinking about what I was doing with my life, you know, I finally just said fuck it. You know, and sometimes that's what you have to do. You have to say fuck it sometimes. You know, I truly believe, and this is something that I want y'all to develop as well, if y'all haven't already, but with me, I truly believe anything that I put my mind to, I can accomplish. And you know, it might take years, but eventually I will accomplish that thing. And I want y'all to have that same mindset. Anything that you want to do with your life, anything that you're passionate about, anything that you want to pursue, you can fucking do it. And never let anyone tell you otherwise. And that's the truth. So, you know, with this LA move, it was very sudden. You know, I never thought I'd be living in LA. And, you know, the crazy thing is I'm leaving today. So it's insane, bro. And it still hasn't kicked in yet for me. There's so many things I have planned for the future that I'm very, very excited for y'all to see. And it's going to be awesome. And y'all are going to be here with me in this journey, together. And it's crazy, man. It really is, bro. It really is. I never expected any of this, you know, being able to move out of my house at 19 years old, is wild. Completely turning my life around in a span of 3 years is insane to me. You know, I wasn't the same person I was, you know, a couple years back. And, you know, I had to do a lot of growing up. You know, I had to mature a lot, had to learn a lot. And, you know, I've had my ups and downs. Never give up. Because God is not putting something in your path to harm you. He's putting in your path to make you stronger. And that's kind of how I treat all my battles now. Anytime I have a situation in my life come up that, you know, makes me feel negative, you know, I try my best to stay positive and stay optimistic because, you know, I know I'm going to be okay. It's very exciting. It's very scary, but I'm just grateful that, you know, I'm taking the risk. That concludes the talk. You know, I haven't had one of those in a while, but yeah, it's crazy. I can give you a little tour of the crib I grew up in, I guess. This was the room I grew up in. There's my favorite poster, Scarface. You already know we got the drip on and shit, bro. The drip always stay on. What else? This is a really cool painting I got a while back. And this girl I actually dated made me this. This was a long time ago. Actually, no. It was 2020. Look at what that says, bro. It's wild. You already know we got Matt in the cut.
What's up?
I told Matt because I just cleared out my whole closet and I have a lot of clothes left. That he could grab whatever the fuck he wants. And bro, for my hometown homies watching this, if y'all want anything, let me know, bro. Just fucking text me because there is a lot of clothes here for y'all. But let's see some of the drip that Matt got. Matt got the Immortals in the green, Fuego. And he also got them in the purple, Fuego. And then some chill-ass joggers and shit. Youngla providing, as always. And then he got the OG Revenge hoodie. I told bro he could have this. This means a lot to me. It's a sick ass fucking hoodie. It's in good hands though. Then we got the Youngla. And then, I'm guessing this is this Vicel?
I think so.
It's a Vicel. And then some more Youngla. It's a pretty good haul, bro.
Thanks, bro.
But yeah. Yo, what's good, family? Welcome back. Your boy's currently in LA. I spent a couple days in New York, then I spent one day in Houston. Now I'm here for another Young LA photo shoot, which I'm honestly pretty excited about because last night I was downstairs and my homie Zay was here, which she's also part of Young LA. And then they added us into this group chat and John's also in the group chat. So y'all are probably gonna be seeing some John content today. I don't really know what this shoot is, but apparently we're gonna be going to the new Young LA gym, which is not done being built, but I'm very excited to see it. I genuinely had no plan on moving here whatsoever, but I had a massive opportunity come up here with Young LA. I didn't wanna miss out on the opportunity. And you know, I was talking to my family about it because they weren't super happy that, you know, I'm moving to LA. I told them, I was like, I have to take the risk. I have to take this chance. You know, I said, fuck it. And I have to do it. That's how I've always been. You know what I'm saying? I might be a very impulsive person,
and it might bite me in the ass every now and then, but I know when I trust myself and I trust my instinct, I accomplish whatever the fuck I set my mind to. And I want y'all to remember that as well. You know, when you're scared to jump, fucking do it, bro. Do it. And that's what I'm doing right now. So your boy is gonna be moving to LA. It's gonna be a new massive arc. I'm super excited. There's gonna be so much more content to film over here compared to Houston, because Houston doesn't have that much stuff to do. But over here, bro, you can wake up in the morning, go to the beach, afternoon, go skiing, at night, go to the desert. You can do all of those things in Cali, which is crazy. I mean, there's a lot of like negative shit that comes with living here. Hold up. I low-key need to take a shit. But we don't like to focus on the negatives. We like to stay positive over here, baby. We also got the merch coming too, which is gonna be super dope. I just got off the phone with the guy doing my merch, and we had a little setback, but I gotta figure all that shit out. So, but yeah, no, that shit's coming soon. Oh, yeah, I also got this brand new toy, which I'm super excited to use. Shout out Drew for the inspiration. This is my baby, and we're gonna be using her today. So yeah. Need I say more? I'm gonna try not to bust my ass while I'm riding this bitch, but we're here at the Youngla gym, which, god damn, I almost fucking fell, bro. Fuck. We're here at the Youngla gym. It's not done being built, but bro, this bitch is about to be so sick, and it's only for Youngla athletes, which is pretty tight. Currently on the skateboard and shit. Here with the boys, Boosh. In the building, we got Zay in the building, we got LT in the building, Madrip in the building, Ellie in the building, and the one and only in the building. Oh. Oh. I'm gonna stop riding this bitch, bro. I'm done. I'm not riding this song no more. I'm gonna end up breaking something, bro. Fuck. But this is the clothes that we're gonna be shooting today, type shit. Here we go. We got Jerm, and then. Bro, they got Jeremy. They got me by my government, bro. That's crazy. Where's John, though?
John ain't here yet.
He's not coming?
No. He said he's sick, bro.
Fuck. I guess John's not coming anymore, which is kind of a bummer. I wanted to see, bro. I haven't seen bro in a minute, so it would have been cool. The vision behind the shoe is like some like NBA, like all-star tunnel kind of red carpet runway. So we're going to have the drip on. We're going to be walking through that bitch and shit. Yeah, I don't even know if y'all find this like entertaining, so I'm not even gonna try to explain that much, but this is really it. Place is massive though, bro. Okay, all right, pimps, we have finished up the shoot. It was a good like 3-4 hour shoot, but it was pretty fun. Got to do a lot and just chill. Got a little fucking mirror over here so y'all can see the drip. Bro, check out this shirt. The shirt drops February sometime, but the reason I really fuck with it is because of the sleeves. It's like that oversized, great pump cover, also great going out shirt type shit. We're gonna go back to the hotel. And then I think later tonight, we're gonna be working out with Zay and Johnny. The boys wanted to go work out at Zoo Culture, but I was like, oh. I don't know if I'm trying to go work out at that gym, bro, to be honest with you. I don't know, that gym's just like, that's all I'm gonna say. That's all I need to say type shit. But I'm really excited for this gym to be ready. Gary said it's gonna be ready hopefully by May. So that's gonna be coming up within the next couple of months, which will be dope because this is where I'm gonna be shooting all like my annual gym content and shit on this channel. And yeah, dude, like I said, I'm gonna be moving here and I'm super excited because there's just so much to do here, bro. Like, I don't know, I feel like the content's gonna go up even more. But I'm gonna take y'all along the ride. We just finished up. Fucking love y'all. Hey. Let's go. What's good, pimps? I am currently at the one and only infamous Zoo Culture. I'm not gonna lie, this gym is pretty sick. I think Brad actually did a really good job with this gym. The only thing I have to say is the day pass is absolute tax and it's not 24 hours. So if you're gonna buy a day pass here, you can only use it for that day. You can't use it the next day. You can't use it for the next 24 hours, which honestly sucks, but it's whatever. I'm here with the one and only Zay, and we're about to go get a little push workout in. He's gonna put me through some shit because this motherfucker's a bodybuilder, so he's gonna let me know how it goes. And I haven't worked out hard in a minute, so I'm honestly pretty excited about this workout, and I'm gonna take y'all through it. We're gonna be filming on the VHS camera, so y'all about to see some crazy ass shit, bro.
Sitting in a hotel room, I just feel so lonely, bro.
I feel that,
you
bro.
You feel me, bro?
Yeah. Especially when you don't got your girl and shit.
No, bro. This is my first time away from my girl, like 5 months, and I was like, I've been like legit FaceTiming the whole time.
That's love. Hey, that's what I'm trying to find, bro. Fuck all these hoes. I'm trying to find me a wife, but hey, we're about to get into this shit, baby. Let's go. Yo, what's good, pimps? Welcome back. It is currently the next day. Yesterday we went, bro, I hope y'all know this. I don't know if anyone really knows this about me, but hold up. English is not my first language, bro. So I tend to fuck up words, and I sometimes do not pronounce the words right, or sometimes I can't, yeah. Okay, yesterday we went thrifting and shit. A lot of the thrift stores were closed, so we weren't able to go to that many. We went to like three, and I want to show y'all what I copped, but I'm gonna wait till like we're back in the crib and stuff. But bro, I got some fire fucking shit for such a good price. I got these jeans that are typically $225, got them for $33, and then I got this Stussy like knit kind of like zip up for $80, which I don't know if that was kind of, I don't know if that was a steal, but I really wanted it because it looked really cool. And yeah, so today we're gonna be going to Rick Owens store. We're gonna go to a couple other stores. I texted my friend that lives here, and he suggested me a good amount of stores. So that's basically what we're gonna be doing today. But before we fucking go on, dude, this is crazy. So as of recently, Trippie Redd has dropped a new album. And I'm not gonna lie to y'all, I do not fuck with Trippie Redd. I like his old music because I don't feel like he was jacking anyone's style. He was being like more on his wave, but as of recently, he's been trying to like fit in with like this new rap shit. I don't think he's doing a great job because he's just jacking people's flows and shit. Like, I'm gonna show y'all right now. So there's a song called GTA by Can Can. This came out a while ago, like a while ago. And it's hella hard. I'm gonna play for y'all right now. Let's consider this a song of the day, because it's actually a really good song. Hear the beat and hear the flow. Alright, you hear how fucking fire that shit is. Alright, I'm gonna play y'all something now. I'm gonna play y'all Mansion Music by Trippie Redd. And tell me this motherfucker was not jacking Can Can's flow, bro. Same beat, just different. I'm not gonna lie, the beat is fucking fire though. It really is. Bro, he is literally Can Can's son, bro. Trippie, be on your own fucking wave. Stop being on this like Can Can bullshit, bro. Damn.
Look at Shorty's drip. Shorty's drip crazy.
So we have made it to the first store. This one is super sick. It's actually at a coffee shop, and then you have to go through this door. So it's like a hidden fashion store, which is super dope. I don't wanna like film in front of all these people and shit. Your boy's like low key like nervous. Actually, fuck that. Fuck that, we filming.
It's pretty dope.
I also don't know if I can film. I'm gonna let y'all know if I find anything too. But there's like a lot of different items here, and also a lot of them are like really well priced. I'd say like a lot of them are also on sale too, so hopefully I can find some shit. If I find some shit, I'm gonna let y'all know.
These are fucking crazy, bro.
They're low-key sick. They remind me of this one shoe called Osiris. I don't know if y'all heard about that brand back in the day. They were like a really well-known like skater brand and shit. They look exactly like these. And they also look like the ASAP Rocky shoes that he dropped with Under Armour, I think.
Pretty dope, though.
Pretty dope. I'm not gonna lie, I've been looking for like 15, 20 minutes now, and I'm really not finding anything I would personally fucking wear. Like, I cannot see myself wearing some shit
like this. Like,
this is too much for me type shit. But it's just cool to look at. A lot of these things are pretty fucking expensive, I'm not gonna lie to you. But it's really dope. It really is like a sick store.
This is all behind a coffee shop, bro. which is super tight. And there's like, I don't know, there's different like passages and shit. Like this shit is behind a fucking coffee store, which is so tight. That's the door, and you like walk in here, then boom, you got like a hidden fucking fashion store in there and shit.
It was pretty dope. It was a cool experience. I just really didn't find anything for myself, and Shorty didn't find anything for herself. So now we're gonna go to the next location, baby.
All right, pimps, we have made it to the second store. I don't know if I can film in here, but this store is super fucking sick. And I looked it up. It's called Terminal 27, if y'all wanna come visit. It's one of the nicest like fashion stores in the country type shit. Like this place is insane, bro. Check it out. He's probably gonna tell me not to film and shit, but this is like everything right here. It's really dope. Oh, you got like a sales section.
Yo.
Sorry, bro. All right, pimps, we have left Terminal 27, which honestly, that store was really cool. They didn't let me film in there, but at the same time, like I didn't really find anything I personally would wear. A bunch of the shit that they have in these fucking stores are like made for people that want to look like wizards and shit. And personally, I don't want to look like a fucking wizard. But it's a dope store. It honestly was really cool. Like they got like a really cool like design concept around the store. Same with the other store that we went to. And we also checked out Rick Owens' store today. I didn't try to film in there, but I just know for a fact like they wouldn't let me film in there. But yeah, dude, Cali weather is fucking amazing. I'm super excited to be moving here and having this weather every single day instead of that bipolar ass weather they have in Houston. Let's go, baby. Good vibes always. Yo, so we're currently in the hills right now, and there's like all these crazy ass houses, right? You know, they got the crazy fucking views. But bro, in all honesty, like if I was living in the hills, if I had property here type shit, I'd build a fucking castle, bro. Like no one has done that yet, you know what I'm saying? Because I'm not gonna lie, like all these houses look the same, bro. And don't get me wrong, like, you know, that shit's cool and all, because, you know, I mean, I can't say anything. I don't own a house in the hills and shit, but, like, personally, if I did, it'd be a fucking castle. Yeah, I just felt like saying that shit, you know what I'm saying? Like, let me know if y'all agree with me type shit, you know what I'm saying?